Professor Dave again, let's solve some more equations.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We now know the very basics about how algebra works. We have equations which contain one or more variables, and we can solve for these variables by manipulating the equation in various ways. But we will see that the strategies we need to utilize to solve these equations will get more complex as the equations get more complex. Just as with everything else in math, this gets easier with practice. So let's look at situations that are slightly trickier than the simplest ones we have learned. If we have 3x plus 7 equals 16, we see that there are two things we have to do, since x is involved in both a product and a sum. But what do we do first? If we divide by 3 first, things get tricky, because we have to divide both sides by 3, and on the left, that means the whole side, not just 3x. So we would get 3x plus 7 over 3 equals 16 thirds. That just made things worse, so instead, let's subtract 7 first. That gives us 3x equals 9, and then we can divide to get x equals 3. So we can see that it will typically be the case that we should do addition and subtraction before we do multiplication and division when solving algebraic equations. Now let's try another one. Here we have 4x plus 3 equals x minus 6. We can see that since there is now more than one x term, we will need to perform operations to get a single x term by itself in order to solve the equation. When we have several terms like this, our strategy should be to do whatever we need to do to get all of the x terms together first. In this case, the easiest way to do that is to subtract x from both sides. If we do that, we get 4x minus x plus 3 on the left, and when we see something like this, we can combine like terms. We have one x term and another x term, so we can combine them to get 3x, since 4 minus 1 equals 3. The x doesn't go away, it's the common term that allows us to subtract, just the way 4 apples minus 3 apples equals 1 apple, not just the number 1. So this leaves us with 3x plus 3. On the right, the x will go away, because x minus x equals 0. Now we have 3x plus 3 equals negative 6. We will want to get all the numbers together, and we should do it in such a way that gets the x term by itself. That means our next move should be to subtract 3 from both sides. That will get rid of this 3 on the left, and after we combine like terms, we get negative 9 on the right. Now for the last step. Since we have 3x, we will need to divide by 3. That leaves us with x equals negative 3. So that problem took 3 steps, which is certainly more than one, but we will later see plenty of examples that require much more manipulation than this. So let's try some even harder examples. How about this one? The quantity of 3 minus 3x over 4 equals 3 times the quantity of 2x plus 1. We want to combine the x terms, but we can't do this the way things look right now. First, let's distribute the 3 on the right side and get 6x plus 3. Now we have this fraction on the left that we would like to get rid of. To do that, we can multiply both sides by 4. At this point, let's acknowledge that an easier way to conceptualize a step like this is to acknowledge that whatever is in the denominator of one side can be pulled up to the numerator of the other side, and anything in the numerator of one side can be pulled down to the denominator of the other side. Pulling this 4 up over here is the same thing as multiplying both sides by 4, because it will cancel out on the left and then appear on the right. But instead of having to write 4s and cancel 4s and perform all of these extra steps each time, it's good to get used to this simpler way of thinking and realize that we can just grab the 4 and put it over here, making sure to put it outside of some parentheses since it must multiply the entire expression. We multiply through and get 24x plus 12. Now we are ready to combine x terms. Adding 3x to both sides, we get 27x over here, and then we can subtract 12 from both sides, and we get negative 9 equals 27x. At this point, let's just flip the equation around so that the x term is on the left side, as we just prefer to read equations that way. Lastly, we can divide by 27, and negative 9 over 27 can be reduced to negative 1/3. So that took a couple more steps than the last example, but each individual step was pretty easy. We will find that a lot of algebra works this way. We may have to develop a strategy to solve an equation, and that strategy could have lots of steps, which means lots of opportunities to make a mistake. But as long as we are meticulous as we move through each step and perform careful arithmetic, it is typically not too difficult to find the answer. Let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.